Something on your mind, Franz? Something on your mind?
Well, well, nothing new.
I wonder if talking about it might not relieve some of the tension.
I don't know.
Do you want to try?
Well, I don't know where to start.
One place to start is with the thing that's most troubling you.
Oh. Well, there was a girl. I guess there's always a girl. And there was a friend. I guess there's always a friend. But they're not anymore. They were killed.
Killed? You say they were killed?
Yes. And I think I know who did it. I want to find out for sure, but I...
So it must be very difficult.
Other people don't make it easy.
Oh, what I was going to say was it must be very difficult to handle something like that, huh? Sounds, by the way you're talking about it, that you're taking a lot of the responsibility on yourself to try to do something about it.
Well, it doesn't seem like anyone else would believe me.
If you tell me what happened, maybe... Maybe I can do something.
You may remember that there were these murders, unexplained murders in the town during Fasching.
What? During what?
Fasching, Faschnacht. Mardi Gras. Fat Tuesday, Carnival.
Yes.
Well, here in the north it's called Fasching, and the locals keep a revel going from New Year to Lent.
I see.
Well, it was around this time that these deaths, you must have heard about it.
And what happened to you and your friends is tied up with the killings.
Well, for me it started earlier.
Yes?
I was attending the university here, you see, pursuing postgraduate studies. The Berlin literary magazines were accepting a few of my essays and my poems. Then, I don't know what happened. This presentiment came over me. Tension and gloom engulfed me. It's as if... there's a room in my soul, a kind of sanctum, and I can go normally. I mean, I can enter this room and shut out the world and compose my thoughts in quiet and comfort. And one day, I couldn't get in. Someone had locked me out of my own soul. Whoever it was, I could feel a presence, a predator, crouched in the shadows of my being, inhabiting me, lying in wait. When the first body was discovered, I was overcome with panic. I realized that all of my disquiet emanated from some source outside of me, that it augured something terrible that was now coming to pass, and that I was totally helpless to stop it. And then there was a second body, and a third. The tumult inside me grew unbearable. Only drink could provide me any sort of relief. And when I had nearly exhausted my meager income in the Ratskellers, I substituted ether. At last, my constitution utterly collapsed, so that when Anna came to my garret looking for me, I couldn't even rise from my cot to answer her knock. The landlord had to let her in. Anna wired Carl in Frankfurt on Main, where he was studying, and he dropped everything to come to see me. Together, Carl and Anna nursed me and amused me until I regained some strength and spirit. They finally coaxed me into the open air, and we set out to betake ourselves of whatever amusement we could find in our frightened little town.
I think we could all agree that madness is a state of mind.
Indubitably.
Axiomatic.
And you will concede that Fasching is the height of madness?
If you say so.
For the sake of argument.
Kind of you both. And where, during Fasching, does madness rule with an absolute divine right?
Munich.
Chicago.
The fair.
The fair?
Yes, comrades, right here. Amidst these tents and booths and teeming masses of so-called humanity.
And the significance of this fact.
Search for significance in anything Carl says, and you search in vain.
I shall ignore that impious jeer at my divine eloquence.
Infernal prolixity.
In the interest of the point I was trying to make.
Namely,
the cure of your madness.
I mad?
Can you deny it? Anyone who can remain morose and hollow-eyed in the company of yon radiant angel and my brilliant wit must perforce be mad.
Oh, am I so...
Gothic, yes. Were your face any longer, you'd trip over your own chin.
Wherefore does my countenance deserve that bar?
Wherefore does my repartee deserve that countenance?
Your repartee...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.